hear all of your questions. We kind of wanted to take this opportunity to share a little bit of our stories. Chris and I actually met through an organization that I founded back in 2011. It's called the Philadelphia SPinCo Coalition. Traveling empathy in the arts. It's kind of amazing how it all came together, and I really can't quite tell you exactly what inspired me to start this. Honestly, I thought it was crazy. I think my family did too. Thank you, God. I really appreciate you. Dad, you're awesome. My uncle, aunt, and uncle. This is actually his first time he's ever been to a SPinCo related function since 2011. So, seriously, thank you. Yes, it's not just some crazy kids on the street school who may know there's actually a real meaning to it. And that meaning has led to over 5,000 students coming into workshops and classes over the last 8 years, which is amazing. Our amazing executive director, Becca, who's actually filming right now, she is the first follower, and that is really one of the most underestimated forms of leadership that not a lot of people talk about. It's about passing the torch. It's about understanding and creating an opportunity where you didn't think existed. And that's exactly what we did. Flow Arts, which is what all this is all about, is a concept. It's a merging of all different types of art forms in dance, but with a prop. So hula hooping, juggling, circus, it's a mix of all different types of performance art. But one thing in common with a prop. So what you do with the prop is really up to you. It's all about creating and exploring and just going through the trials and errors of becoming who you want to be in life. You're going to drop it a lot. You're going to fail a lot. But failing is ultimately good. What I really found the most impressive was the ability to bring people together and create a community. It started with just my friend and I. We decided that it was too cold to hoop outside, and I was tired of my fingers getting crushed. And it really hurts when it's cold. This was in FDR Park in Philadelphia, and we found a space, and I didn't really realize how important finding a space to create was. And at this time in particular was when this whole flow arts movement started to come into the picture. It's this merge, this all of these different cultures coming together and creating something. And that's really what it is. Over the years, I've gotten to host at my house, let's say like 20 to 30 artists from all around the world. Yes, I've definitely traveled, but I've definitely taken a break from traveling, and I've gotten to live precariously through the amazing artists that I've gotten to host. And that's pretty cool. Being able to ask someone about their experiences and allow that to shape how you project your own self-image and your art, and allowing other people to experiment what you put in front of them. So Chris and I, we actually met because of a SPinCo workshop. Now Chris lives in Lancaster, and he's going to give you his little story. And I was living in Philadelphia at the time, and I still am, South Philly. And we met during a SPinCo function. And what's really cool about what we created in Philly was that we were able to activate other areas, regional. All the way down to Baltimore, State College area, Pittsburgh. The amount of people that we've been able to activate these little communities in is pretty impressive, just by the generosity and empathy that we've created in our little circle. And the Lancaster School of Circus Arts is actually one of those projects that Chris actually helped formulate. So I'm gonna kind of give it to Chris to kind of talk about himself.
So when I started with